Hello, friends. Hello, hello. Happy greetings, happy tidings to you wherever you are. Welcome to today's show. Thanks for joining me. I am Jennifer from Personal Power, Wellness Coaching, Life Coaching, Vitality Coaching, reminding you and me to continue living well, in balance, in harmony with the universe and the planet, the forces of the world. And I wanted to show you sprouts that I have grown in the kitchen, and I'm really happy with them and proud of them because they grew so well. And this is the second batch of sprouts that I have succeeded with. So I had previously sprouted in New York about 2 years ago. I did lentil sprouts, which are awesome, very tasty. And I did also, I think, garbanzo or chickpeas, raw chickpeas that became sprouted, and then I made them into a hummus. However, the hummus did not come out spectacularly delicious, so I think that was a no-go eventually. However, lentils are awesome. I also love alfalfa sprouts. I love bean sprouts, which are also the mung bean sprouts. So you can use the mung bean seed and go through the sprouting process, and then you produce bean sprouts. So let me show you the fenugreek sprouts that I have finished. And this is what we've got. This is what it looks like. So this is the final product of fenugreek sprouts. And essentially what sprouts is, it is the process of taking a seed and letting it moisten and germinate, actually, until it sprouts. And that way you eliminate the exterior that is hard and difficult for the body to digest, including some elements which I believe are called lectins, and basically the defense mechanism that plants, seeds have on them to help them survive in the wilderness. So look at how much this is. This, you can clearly see, I mean, it's almost, it's pretty big. And what I did, all it took was, this comes from 1/4 cup of seeds. So just to give you a sense of relativity and ratio, 1/4 cup is this, about this much, or 4 tablespoons. And in terms of the seed, I mean, you can see it fits on my palm, and then just using water, and it multiplied into this huge amount, this huge batch. And the benefit of sprouts is that it increases the nutrient capacity and the nutrient load of the food item. So if you consume broccoli sprouts, they are much more packed, jam-packed with nutrition, with flavor profiles. This has been scientifically studied in research studies, and hence it's more beneficial to have sprouts if you're having a food that can be sprouted, having the seed that can be sprouted, because you'd be getting a double, triple, a multiplied amount of the nutrients that are in that seed. So it's really bang for your buck, because honestly, you can buy a bag of about 250 grams of this, and it multiplies. And a bag of these seeds, you know, will cost, depending on where you go, if you buy organic seeds, it can be in dirhams, it can be less than 5 dirhams. And just to show you what these are, this is a fenugreek or methi, and methi is extremely beneficial. This is what I had bought. These are methi seeds, organic, Indian, and this lasted me since February. Not that I was sprouting consistently every week. Actually, I just started sprouting last week, and I had good success. I also sprouted red clover sprouts, and I have them actually growing here. So let me show you what it looks like. And hello to everyone who may be joining. So I'm about to have dinner, and the nice thing about sprouts is that you can have them anytime, whether it's in a smoothie or whether it's in your meal. You just consume them as is. I really enjoy having them just on their own with one of my vegan dressings. So this is the setup that I've been, that I've sort of elaborated, and there are more sophisticated official types of setups. So just to give you a sense, and then these are the red clover sprouts, if you can see that. And they are coming out quite nice. They have multiplied. This was also just about 3 to 4 tablespoons. 3 to 4 tablespoons. So that was literally less than this 1/4 cup. And it's now blossoming into this batch. Plus, I also have some here, which this is a mesh that I use to cover it up. And look at this, friends. This is also really significant. So if you can see that, it for comparison, it's like, it's a big amount, you see? And it multiplied from 1/4 cup, which is, I mean, comparatively speaking, it's quite minuscule. And it multiplied into this batch. And also I have another one right here, which is also in the process of growing. And I think it's already finished sprouting. And this has been after about 4 days of the sprouting process. And you can see, and look how it becomes. It's really beautiful. It's amazing. And so it started out with a small batch. And if you look closely, you'll see that some of it is starting to produce these green little leaves or across the top or little buds, and that is so exciting. Look at that, friends. That's really, really beautiful. They're also very tasty. I really enjoy tasting eating these. So just to give you a sense of how much food you can produce with just some seeds, it's really affordable. We have this batch over here, we have this batch of the red clover, and we've got this one right here. So I find that to be extraordinary, and that's why I'm making this video, is to share with you the bounty and the blessings of sprouts. And then we've got here our fenugreek batch that came from a small cup. So I mean, basically from this small cup, 1/4, it multiplied into this bigger quantity. So this goes to show that it's just really simple and possible. It's possible to create something and have fun in the process. And sprouting is a great way to increase the nutrients that you're taking into your body. It's low calorie. It is incredibly nutritious. It's nice to the palate. You can blend it in smoothies. You can have it on your sandwiches. You can mix it in your salads. You can just have it as it is. I enjoy it with my fruits and my dressings. And it's really simple, and you can sprout so many different kinds of seeds. There's sunflower seed sprouts, alfalfa, bean sprouts. Like, for instance, a really popular one I'll show you is the bean sprout, which I also bought yesterday because I haven't grown it yet. But this is one such sprout. These are bean sprouts. And I could probably, I paid one dirham and 63 fils for this package of 235 grams. And at the same time, you could probably buy the seeds that could help you to make these friends, these babies, over time, and pay perhaps just as much for a whole bag that can give you maybe 4 weeks worth supply of this. So I just find it to be really fascinating and pretty awesome that you can do it so simply. And all it takes is soaking the seeds for 24 to 8 hours, depending on the seed that you're treating. And then after the soaking period, you then set it aside in the container that is the sprouting jar or the sprouting tray. And there are full videos that are detailed in how to do this. But basically, for me, it was really, I just made it really simple. I use the colander or these sifters, and I put some napkins at the bottom after it started sprouting, because they start to produce little tails and the tails will grip onto the bottom of the mesh. So in order to preserve the integrity of the sprout and to not damage the tail, I just made sure that it was protected with the napkin. And if you take a look at this one is really growing like in a pad. It's really cool. As we can see, it just dries. And this one, you just need to spray some water on it once a day, not too much, and it really starts to grow beautifully. The fenugreeks, you just toggle them around after you soak them, and then when you rinse them, you put them in the container, and then twice a day you wash them and rinse them, and then you let them dry in a ventilated sort of setup, which is that's the purpose of this particular mesh item. Of course, they sell full-fledged sprouting utensils online, in person. You can use a mason jar, you can use a glass jar or a container. I just used my reusable plastic containers from times that I purchased them at the supermarket. That way it doesn't go to waste. We help the environment by reducing plastic wastage, and you give yourself the opportunity to have some fun in the kitchen making sprouts, wholesome and nutritious and tasty. Yeah, delicious indeed. So that's my sprout update, my sprout story for tonight, the wellness segment. Perhaps it encourages you, it inspires you, and motivates you to include some sprouts in your nutrition, at least on a weekly basis. And know that this can be one form of giving yourself even more nutrient load, more benefits, and to have fun in the process. So get yourself some seeds, try lentils. Lentils tend to be very well received and popular. I love lentils, and they are a fantastic source of protein. If you want to reduce your animal food products and you want to consider going more plant-based, then sprouts can definitely be part of your repertoire to make your meals enjoyable, varied, and tasty, and creative, and even fun-filled, as something you can share with your family. So that's it for now, friends. Thank you for joining. Here we have the sprouts already ready to be enjoyed. And let me know if you try your own sprouting, if you have your own sprouts from time to time. It's a must-have, really. I mean, eventually you really get to the point. And it really is an example, as Joanne, you're saying, small amounts give you a great abundance and bounty. And that is true abundance, prosperity, and well-being. And that's you thriving at your utmost. So go ahead, enjoy the abundance that surrounds you, that is here for us, and let's enjoy our sprouts and sprouting. Awesome. Enjoy, lots of love, and see you soon. And thank you for watching. Bye from Jen at Personal Power Life Coaching for Wellness. Namaste.